the janas, that is mahajanapadas and janapadas. So in this lesson, it is also going to continue. Okay, already I have told you about janapadas and mahajanapadas, and about the Vedic literatures too. So what are the four Vedas and about the Varna system? Okay, so this lesson is a continuation of the early Vedic, that is the fifth lesson. That is, wait, I'll tell you what is the name of the fifth lesson, the Vedic age. So what all you have studied in fifth lesson, you are going to study in this lesson too. Okay, so it is a continuation part only. So we'll see about that. So first we'll see the introduction part. That is rise of kingdoms and empires. So the name of the lesson is early states. So what are the states, what are the empires and the kingdoms which came into existence in the olden period? So now we are going to see about that only. Okay, so the formation of the early states marked the beginning of the new chapter in Indian history. So in Indian history, we know that early states, that is some of the kingdoms and empires, came into existence, and it was a mark in the Indian history. And next is the political organization. So what do you mean by political organization? So political means, in English, in Tamil, you know that arasiyal, yes or no? So political organization is nothing but arasiyal. So it is about making agreements. So it is making about political means. It is making about making agreements between people and the government. That is, so they can live together in groups, such as tribes, cities, or countries. So that is what political organization. And these people who are governing the country, they are called as politicians. Okay. So politicians and sometimes other people make government. So this is what political organization, and which is a central feature of the central feature during the olden period, political organization. And next, with the rise of the Janapadas and the Mahajanapadas, kingdoms and empires came to replace the small tribal units of the Vedic age. Yes, in the Vedic period, we know that people formed the tribal groups, and later they increased in number. Okay, and they occupied more number of regions. Okay, and then it leads to the existence of more number of empires, since people increased in number. Okay, so now here the Janapadas and the Mahajanapadas form the kingdoms and the empires. Before and all, only small group of people were living. But later, as they increased in number, what happened? It led to the formation of Janapadas and Mahajanapadas. Okay. So now we are going to see. So with this political change, all the aspects in the life underwent many changes in the olden period. So now we are going to see about that. So the political developments of the later Vedic period led to the rise of the early states. So when these early states, that is the empires and kingdoms, came into existence during, that is between 600 to 400 BCE. So these states had become as kingdoms. So these states later, they as the people increased in number, more number of people came and settled in this region. And this region began as kingdoms, with well-defined territories, where powerful kings, for I told you that each jana, that is the group of people, was ruled by the king or the ruler. So now as they increase in number, these janapadas and mahajanapadas were ruled by the powerful kings. Okay, and they gradually increased into huge empires. Next is sources. So what do you mean by sources? That is the origin. Where did it start from? So most of what we know about the early states in this period comes from literature. Yes. How we'll come to know about the olden period? Only by reading the literature. that is the textbooks. Either it might be religious or normal one. So these information about the olden period we come to know only by reading the literature, that is nothing but the textbooks. So that was written and composed during the later Vedic age. So what are the literature? First one is the three later Vedas. So what are the first, which was the first Veda which was composed? Rig Veda. But the other three Vedas, they're called as the later Vedas, that is Yajur, Sama and Atharva. Okay, Yajur, Sama and Atharva Veda were the three later Vedas which were composed during the later Vedic age. And next one is the Brahmanas, the Upanishads, the Buddhist texts such as the Jatakas and Jain texts. All these are the literatures which have been composed during the later Vedic age. Understood? So Rig Veda was composed in the early period, but in the later Vedic age, what happened? The remaining three Vedas, that is Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharva Veda, were composed. Along with that, the Brahmanas, the Upanishads and the Buddhist texts such as the Jatakas and the Jain texts, all these were considered as the literature. These texts and literature were composed during the later Vedic age. Understood? Can I question now? Now you all can type. So what were the literature which was composed during the later Vedic age? Can you all type the answer for this? Navinaitya, what meant? What is this? What do you mean by the word DOB? What question I'm asking? I'm asking you, what are the literature which was composed during the later Vedic period? Yes, Samaveda, Yajurveda and Atharva Veda, along with that. What is these, sir? What are the other textbooks? Brahmanas, very good, Sai Raghav. Rig Veda, no, Rig is wrong. Rig Veda won't come during the later Vedic period. In the early Vedic age itself, Rig Veda was composed. I'm asking about the literature which were composed during the later Vedic age. Now only I thought you all. Jain texts, yes, Buddhist texts such as the Jatakas, then the Brahmanas, the Upanishads, understood? Then the later three Vedas, that is Samaveda, Yajurveda and Atharva Veda. Children, once again I'm telling you all, kindly listen to the class. Don't sit idle. I can see only the same children typing the answer. I don't know what the rest of you all are doing. The same children, Bhavadharani, Sai Raghav, Shivesh, Navinaitya, Alan, Jaina, like this, these children only are typing the answer. Avardhana, like this children, Nauful Ahmed, Kamima. Now only I can see. So kindly listen to the class. Unless and until you all listen, I cannot proceed. Okay. So now we'll switch on to the next topic, that is Janapadas and Mahajanapadas. So we have learnt about this topic in the previous lesson, that is the Vedic age. Okay. So now you have to answer me. Okay. Are we ready now? So what do you mean by the word Jana? the word, the term Jana? Very good, Badarni. Very good, Sairagal. Good. Yes. Tribe or people. Okay, Jana means in Tamil we used to say as Makkal. So each Jana had a dash rule. Very good. What is the other name for Rajan? What is... See here, don't look at the book and answer. I don't want that. Yes, Rajan is otherwise called as king. Very good, children. Very good. Okay, 1 minute. In the early Vedic age, the Vedic age has been divided into... Early Vedic age has been divided into two periods. Okay. In the early Vedic age, Rig Veda was composed. But in the later Vedic age, I told you now. So what are the textbooks? What are the literature which have been composed during the later Vedic age? That is Yajur, Sama and Atharva Veda. Along with this, the Brahmanas, the Upanishads, then Buddhist texts such as the Jatakas, as well as Jain texts. Good. Okay. So now I'll tell you. So many tribes joined together to form the Jana. Okay. Each Jana was headed by and ruled by the king, the Rajan. Okay. Then each Jana formed many villages that is called as Gramas. In Tamil, we used to say as Gramam. So each Grama formed many families. It is formed of many families. And each Gramam, that is Grama, had a leader. He is called as the village headman, that is Gramani. Okay. So now we are going to see about that. The term Janapada is derived from the word Jana. So what do you mean by Jana? Jana means people, tribe, Makkal. Okay. Yes. So meaning that tribe. And what do you mean by the word Pada? Foot. We in Tamil we used to say padam, foot. Okay, pada means foot. That is the word Janapada means that is the area where the tribe put its foot down. That is, these group of people are living in particular area or region. So we know that in the olden days, the early human beings were moving from one place to another place in search of food, water, and shelter. But later, what happened? As they started discovering, as they started to learn about how to do farming, they settled near the banks of the river. As they started to settle near the banks of the river, they started to do more number of occupations such that they settled. They led a settled life. They started earning money without moving from one place to another place. So more number of occupations came into existence. So people settled in one place and they did not move in search of food, water and shelter. Such that they did occupations like farming, agriculture, that is agriculture, then trading by making use of the river. They started to do trading, then rearing of animals, domestication of animals, then fishing, building boats, weaving baskets. So many things. So they settled near the rivers. And this led to the formation of later as they formed the groups, that is the tribes. What happened? They increased in the community, which led to the formation of the kingdoms, which was ruled by the king or the Rajan. So that is called as Janapadas. Since people settled in one place, that term Janapada, Jana means people or tribe, group of people. Pada means what? Food. Such that they settled in one place and they did not move in search of food, water and shelter. Okay, next, stop typing. Now listen to the class. So the formation of the Janapadas can be traced back to when the Janas of the later Vedic period started establishing the settlements in the region of the Ganga Yamuna Dobe. Yes, now only I told you, the early human beings were moving from one place to another in search of food, water and shelter. But as they slowly started learning how to cultivate the land, they settled near the rivers. That is which place, which region? Dob. What do you mean by the word Dob? D-O-A-B. D-O means two. Okay, D-O means what? Two. Ab means the region between two rivers. The region between two rivers. Because the region they settled was near the banks of the river. And just think, the Ganga, Yamuna, Dob. So these rivers are very, very fertile. The northern plain was very, very fertile. Why? Because of the alluvium and the silt brought down by these rivers. As these rivers arise from the snow-capped region, that is the Himalayas. Okay. And these rivers, along with them, they bring the alluvium and silt and get deposited in the northern plains such that this region, the Ganga Yamuna Dob, is very, very fertile and it is suitable for growing crops. Understood? So this is the reason why the Janapadas, the group of people, tribal people, settled in this region. Once again, I tell you, what is the term Dob means? Dob, D-O-A-B. Do means what? Two. Two rivers. Ab means the region between two rivers. Do means two. Ab means the region between two rivers. Understood? So this is the meaning of Dob. Ganga, Yamuna. Ganga and Yamuna are the two rivers. Understood? So the region between two rivers is very, very fertile. Such that the people, that is the Janapadas, they settled in this region. In order to survive, in order to do, that is growing crops, what they did? They settled near the river. So they need river for the basic needs and to grow crops. For this purpose, they settled there. Understood? So next one. Soon the Janas began fighting with each other for control over cows, sheep and pasture land. Yes. As they grew in number, what happened? These people started to settle there near the river. They wanted to occupy the particular region. So this, I need this place. So I am going to do this occupation. I am going to take care of the cows. We are going to rear animals like a cows, then sheep. Yes or no? So they started to fight. So they wanted the cows, the particular pasture land, such that these lands can be grazed by the animals. So for all these things, these people, Janapadas, they started to fight among, that is among themselves within the community. Understood? So now what happening? Listen, the king, the Rajans of the Janapadas started perform rituals. So in the previous lesson itself, I told you, why the kings, Rajans, many rituals, ceremonies, religious ceremonies have been performed by the king. For what purpose? In order to strengthen the power, in order to strengthen the power, the king is making and performing more rituals. And rituals, that is religious ceremony. Okay. That rituals is otherwise called as Ashwamedha Yajna. So you would have seen the king performing the rituals. Yaham Valakradu. Yes or no? By making use of the Brahmanas, they used to do the yajna, that is Ashwamedha Yajna. Okay. So in other words, it is also called as Bali, like that also. So they'll be offering all these things. So more strong and to declare themselves to be the superior over the large areas. Understood? So to make them, to show themselves to be more strong and to show that they are superior among all these people in the larger areas, over the larger areas. And next one, over a period of time, the Janas turn into Janapadas and with clearly defined geographical boundaries. That is, they settled. Before, this group of people, that is the tribal people, the Janas, more number of people came and settled near the boundaries. banks of the river, and they increased in the number, and the region also increased. So become the community changed into kingdom, which was ruled by the king. Okay, next one. By 600 CE BCE, many of the Janapadas expanded into larger kingdoms. Now Jana changed into Janapadas, and Janapadas changed into larger kingdoms, and they started to merge with the neighboring Janapadas, or by conquering more territories. Yes, the king started to conquer, to defeat the other empires, because in order to conquer that empire, he will be fighting the emperor, in order to bring that empire also under his control, his kingdom. So what did he do? Jana slowly became Janapadas, and then into the larger kingdoms. So they started merging with the other Janapadas, other neighboring Janapadas, by conquering the more number of territories, such that the king brought other kingdoms under his control. So these became, as these Jana grew into Janapadas, and then slowly into larger kingdoms, that is nothing but Mahajanapadas. Okay, first one is Jana, that is tribe, and then more number of people came and lived, settled near the banks of the river, and then it led to the formation of Janapadas. And then once again, this the king who was ruling, they also wanted to conquer the other empire and merge with the neighboring territory. And what will happen? Automatically, those territories also will come under the king, under his rule. And now it has been converted, changed into Mahajanapadas. Understood? So what do you mean by the word Maha? Maha means great. Maha means great. We used to say Maha Periyar, Maha Kanji Periyar, like that. Yes or no? So like that. So Maha means great. So the literature of this period mentions the existence of 16 Mahajanapadas. So there were 16 Mahajanapadas which came into existence during the early period, that is the later Vedic period. And we know about all these 16 Mahajanapadas only through the literature, that is the textbooks which was written during the early later Vedic period or age. So who are the 16 Mahajanapadas? Who are the 16 Mahajanapadas? Magadha, Vaji, Kashi, Cheri, Ashmaka, Panchala, Matsya, Kamboja, Anga, Malla, Vatsa, Kosala, Kuru, Shurasena, Avanti, Gandhara. Okay, I repeat it once again. So the 16 Mahajanapadas are, that is Mahada, Vaji, Kashi, Chedi, Ashmaka, Panchala, Matsya, Kamboja, then Anga, Malla, Vatsa, Kosala, Kuru, Avanti, and Gandhara. So these 16 Mahajanapadas, they came into existence when? During the period. And we know about all these 16 Mahajanapadas only through the literature, by reading the literature, that is the textbooks. And next we are going to see about the types of government. Okay, so Mahajanapadas, first I told you the group of people, the early humans settled near the rivers, and slowly they started to form Janas, that is the tribe. And then next to Janas, Janapadas. And then after Janapadas, next is Mahajanapadas, that is the largest kingdom. Okay. Now we are going to see how these Mahajanapadas have been ruled by the kings. So what type of government was ruled by the kings? So what are they? That is, there are two types. That is monarchical type of government. Okay. And the republics or Ganasanghas, which is ruled by the councils. So there are two types of government. One is monarchical government, monarchies, which is ruled by the kings. And next one is republics or Ganasanghas, which was ruled by the councils. So now I'll tell you about monarchy. What do you mean by the word monarch? Monarch means king or queen. So in the olden days, we know that the empire was ruled by the monarch, or that is the king or the queen. Okay. So these were Mahajanapadas ruled by hereditary kings or rajans who are very, very powerful. So automatically we know, unless and until the king is powerful, he cannot rule that empire. So the king or a queen might rule the empire. Okay. So these Mahajanapadas were ruled by the king. For example, take, if a king is not feeling well, okay, he might be sick or he might be defeated by the another king. Okay. Now, who will be? If that particular king is not feeling well, what will happen? Who will be the next person to ascend the throne or to rule the country? That particular empire. Yes, very good, brother. Automatically, the next ruler will be his son. Okay, his son will be the ruler, the king. So that is called as hereditary. So who will ascend the throne? Automatically, his son. Okay, so this is why this monarchy type of government is called as hereditary. So hereditary kings or rajans were very, very powerful. They were ruling the Mahajanapadas. And these kings maintained large armies. So in many movies also you would have seen. So how they used to maintain armies. Because in order to defeat the other emperor, they need the army. Can a single person, the king alone, can go and fight with the next the other emperor? No, it won't be possible. So you want the army. So army plays a major role in the case of monarchical government. Understood? Yes. What I told you, king or queen, if he is not having a son, automatically, if he is having a daughter, automatically the daughter will ascend the throne. She will be taking care of the empire. Understood? So the kings maintained large armies and they collected taxes from different sources. Yes. Can you tell me one source in which the king collecting taxes from the people? One source. Very good. Land tax. Exactly, land tax. Yes, people used to pay tax to the king through the land. That is, land tax are the revenues which are collected from the people. Okay. And these taxes are collected for what purpose? The taxes which are being collected from the people is used for what purpose? To maintain the army. Okay. Because the army members have to be taken care of well. Yes or no? So, and to rule the government. So, for all these things, the taxes have to be collected from the people. So, land tax is one of the main sources such that the people are paying the tax to the king. Understood? And next, examples of the Mahajanapadas that were monarchies are Magadha, Kosala, Vatsa and Avanti. So the example of Mahajanapadas were monarchies. There is the kings. Who are the kings? Magadha, Kosala, Vatsa and Avanti. These places. Okay, so these are the examples of the Maharajas. Okay, time is up, children. With this, we'll end up the session. Tomorrow, we'll continue.